Yes, we can, can, can! Yes, we can, 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 can!
And it's killing me. I wanna show you more. But I can't keep on like this, just being what I've been. Just a girl with a pretty voice who writes you songs and holds you close.
Two jobs. How'd that happen?
You gotta concentrate. Ain't sharp with your two jobs.
Cool. I can do it. As long as I don't get confused.
You get confused real easy.
I don't get confused that easily.
Yes, you do. You're your own worst enemy.
Stop being negative.
I'm not being negative. I'm being realistic.
You'll screw it up.
You always do.
Who screws it up?
You! You're the role model for the village idiots everywhere.
Me? You're nothing without me. You're a cock-up.
Don't call me a cock-up, you cock-up.
You pushed me.
Yeah, I did. And I'm glad I did. That hurt.
Good. You started it.
This summer was the worst summer in my short 14 years of life. It all started with a phone call. My mother was crying, begging, asking for more time as she was gasping for her last breath of air. She held me as tight as she could and cried. Her tears hit my shirt like bullets. She told me we were being evicted. She kept apologizing to me. Thought, I have no home. I should have asked for something less expensive at Christmas time. On the day of the eviction, a hard knock on the door woke me up. It was the sheriff. He was there to do his job. And I looked up at the sky, just waiting for something to happen. Nothing did. My mother has no family to lean on, no money coming in. Why bother coming to school or getting good grades if I'm homeless? The bus stops in front of school. I feel like throwing up. I'm wearing clothes from last year, old shoes, no new haircut. I kept thinking I'd get laughed at. But instead, I'm greeted by a few friends who were in my English class last year. Talking about trips in English, I began to feel better. Then it hits me. Miss Grewell, my crazy English teacher from last year, was the only person that made me think of home. I receive my schedule, and the first teacher I see is Miss Grewell in room 203. I walk into the room, feel as though that all my problems in life are not so important. I am home.
Question. Why is it that I have to take this class every stinking year? I mean, really. I want to know. I mean, every year, it is exactly the same. I'm forced to humiliate myself in front of the rest of the class. I mean, sure, it's not so bad for the kids who are athletes and, ooh, jocks. But the rest of us, like me, it's not so easy. I mean, yes, God, Miss Myers, I know. PE is just like any other class, and you need a grade based on your abilities and your skills. But it's not like they have basic PE, like they have general science or basic math. I mean, seriously, that would be a whole other subject completely. And another thing, why do we have to rotate activities all the time? I mean, soccer and basketball aren't so bad. But this body on a balance beam during gymnastics? You gotta be kidding me. I just become entertainment for the rest of the class. And look, high school is humiliating enough without coming in 5 minutes after everyone else on the mile run. I mean, they're showered and they're going off to lunch, and this poor old me having an asthma attack on the finish line. I know there's not much you can do about it, but thanks for letting me get that off my chest. I'll see you in the gym.
Home in Disneyland.
luxury cars, sir. Are they good runners? Let's put it this way, you wouldn't beat them in a race. Oh. No, sir. Yes, sir. They are good runners, sir. Yes, sir. So, how much exactly?
Ah! Harry!
Hang on.
Look at this. She's reading a book. It's not normal for a five-year-old. I think she might be an idiot. Listen to this. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was an age old of wisdom.
Ah! Stop scaring your mother with that book, boy.
I'm a girl.
And she keeps trying to tell me stories, Harry. Stories. Who wants stories? I mean, it's not normal for a girl to be all thinking.
I'm going to call you right back.
Would you please shut up? I'm trying to pull off the biggest business deal of my life, and I have to listen to this. It's your fault. You spend us into trouble and you expect me to get us out. What am I, a flaming escapologist?
Escapologist. Escapologist, he says. Well, if you're an escapologist, then what am I? Got a whole bling household to run. Dinners don't microwave themselves, you know. If you're an escapologist, I must be an acrobat to balance that lot. The greatest acrobat in the world. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm off to bleach my roots and I shan't be speaking to you for the rest of the evening, you horrid little man.
But I'm going to make us rich.
Rich.
How rich?
Very rich. Russian businessman. Very, very stupid. But Georgina's husband is going to sell 155 knackered old bangers. Those brand new luxury cars.
What? The cars are break down. What about the Russians?
Fair. Listen to the boy.
I'm a girl.
Fair does not get you anywhere in this world. You thick-headed twit brain. All I can say is thank goodness Michael inherited his old man's brains.
Well, I shall take the money when you earn it. And I will spend it. But I shan't enjoy it because of the despicable way which you've spoken to me tonight.
This is your fault. With your stupid books and your stupid reading.
What? That's not right. I didn't do anything.
Right. Right, you're off to school in a few days' time. I'll tell you this. You won't be getting right there. Oh no, I know your headmistress, Agatha Trunchbull. And I've told her all about you and your smarty pants ideas. Big, scary woman she is. Used to compete in the Olympics, throwing the hammer. Imagine what she'd do to a horrible, squeaky little goblin like you, boy.
I'm a girl.
Now get off to bed, you little bookworm.
On the ground, you will be found. 382.
I don't understand. What happened?
You did.
Young, beautiful boy,
miss you, baby boy. We'll miss you, baby boy. Oh, you were the one who gave me life, a reason to wake up and try. So why'd you have to die? You were the one who gave me wings, a reason to wake up today and sing the song of your life. Oh, we'll miss you, baby boy. We'll miss you, baby boy. We'll miss you, baby boy.
Grandma a lot. It's been like that for as long as you can remember. It's easier with her than with your parents. You never quite understood that when you were younger. You just thought her staircase was fun and her dog was cute, but with her it was calmer, slower, more simple. You visited as often as you could, but that changed to once a week once you started school. Grandma watched as you wished for the weekends, for birthdays, for Christmas. And you didn't understand why she wasn't excited like you were. But all she saw was you wishing your childhood away. And that's exactly what happened. As soon the apple juice and fairy bread changed to Pepsi Max and pizza, and then again to tea and chocolate digestives. But after years of routine and weekly visits, yeah, I can't wait to see you. Changes to, oh, sorry, my friends wanted to see me today. Or, oh, I just don't feel too well. But after you miss enough, Grandma's heart breaks as she hears, I just don't feel like it today. The thing is, as you get older, you don't realise how many weeks you miss until bang, 2020 struck with a worldwide pandemic, and now it seems not seeing Grandma for months isn't exactly your choice anymore. It really hits you. And you notice as all those wishes at 11:11 go from I want an iPhone to I want to see Grandma again. And all your worries go from what if they think this dress is ugly? To what if Grandma's not okay? Eventually things get a little bit better and you return to Grandma's house. You start to realise why this always used to mean so much to you. She hadn't touched the biscuits since you left. After all, tea is always better with a chocolate digestive.
Thank you. This is the tale of a stupid and foolish princess who came under companionship of an ugly toad.
You are dismissed. Princess, princess, now that you've aged, I have a surprise for you.
It is a pleasure to meet you, princess, princess. I am Prince Carlos of Toyota. It brings me great pleasure to meet you today in the kingdom of kingdoms.
This is Prince Carlos, to whom thou have been betrothed to marry.
Marry?
Marry.
But I'm only 12.
It is the 14th century. Thou art of age.
Excuse me, but I must excuse myself to lavatories to powder one's nose. I cannot marry him. He's too short.
Well, that was a brief introduction.
As King, King of the Kingdom of Kingdom, I swear upon my name and country that you, Carlos, shall be wed.
Thou who spoke, I'm weeping for my golden ball which slept away and into the water, and my poor, single soul.
Be quiet, and do not cry. I can give thou very good advice, but what will you give me if I fetch your plaything?
What will thou have? My dresses, my pearls, my jewels, or the golden crown which I wear upon my head?
Dresses or jewels or golden crowns do not interest me, but if you will love me and let me be your companion and playfellow and sit at thy table and drink from thy chalice and eat from your golden plate and sleep in thy bed in thy room, if you promise me all of these things, I will dive down and fetch your golden ball.
I promise thee all, if only you get my ball.
I'll be back.
What is that silly frog chattering about? Let him remain in the water with his equals. He cannot mix in with society.
Wait. Wait, come back! I cannot run as thou can!
Compared to what I've seen today, Carlos appears to be a better option.
What did thou see?
Do not worry thyself.
Well, that is certainly an improvement. Now we must decide whether to hold the wedding here or in Toyota.
Oh, but Toyota is so far away. How perfect! Frogs will not find me there. Oh, what a feeling! I've never been to Toyota.
What was that thou said about frogs?
Nothing!
Well, they and Toyota will be utterly delighted to host our wedding in our home kingdom. Oh, what a feeling it will be to be wed in Toyota.
Youngest daughter of the king, open the door.
What does this frog want with you?
Oh, dear father, when I was by the fountain, I dropped my ball and this frog fished it up for me. Oh, but I must tell you, you pressed me so much, I promised you to be my companion. I never thought he would come out of the water, but here he is.
It's a frog. Matters not.
Youngest daughter of the king, open the door. Have thou forgotten what promises made by the fountain clear? Beneath the lime tree's shade, king's daughter youngest, open the door.
What thou promisest, thou must perform. Let him in. Thy king is letting thy daughter create legal bounds with a frog.
Let me up.
Obey, daughter of mine. Excuse me?
Now push thy plate near me and we may eat together.
That is highly unsanitary.
I have satisfied my hunger and now I am very tired. Please prepare your chamber for us to sleep.
He who helped you in your time of trouble must not now be despised. Thy youngest daughter is left in tears. How horrible must one's father be? Carlos.
I am so very tired that I shall sleep well. Do take me up or I will tell your father.
Now will you shut up, you ugly, stupid frog.
Princess, princess, an evil witch cursed me, and no one but you were able to release me from the pond and from this dreadful curse. Now remember by the fountain when you asked me why I was so heavy.
No.
Exposition. In magic, when something is transformed, it carries the same weight. So I was a human-weighted frog. It really does, doesn't it? Anyway, I am so excited to properly introduce myself. I am Prince Frederick Goffredo, and will you be my princess?
Of course! Father! Father! Come at once!
What is this?
I am Prince Frederick Goffredo, and I was cursed into a frog by an evil witch. Thanks to your daughter, I am a man once again.
You must wed us, father. Now.
Now?
Yes, now.
Very well. I shall use the rings I planned for you and Carlo. Oh, Carlos.
Never mind him, father. Wed us.
Wife.
I, Prince Frederick Goffredo, take Princess Princess of Kingdom to be my wife.
And do you, Princess Princess of Kingdom, take Prince Frederick Goffredo as your husband.
I, Princess Princess of Kingdom, take Prince Frederick Goffredo to be my husband.
Now, I would ask if there are any objections, but there's no one present to object. I object! What is your objection, Carlos of Toyotar?
I had to confess my love before it was too late.
Whatever thou hast to confess will not sway my mind.
Oh no, not you, foolish princess. I came here
to confess the deepest and utter passions from the depths of my heart for another. I know that it was to princess I was betrothed, but in truth I love the monk boy. Just kidding, Frederick Alfredo.
Carlos? Of Toyota? Oh, why, I'm your biggest fan! Do accompany me to Fredo, where we shall be happy.
Of course, Frederick.
Well, Carlos, I did promise you would marry. I give you my blessing.
Oh, what a feeling.
I'm ruined.
Alone in this house again tonight. Got the TV on, the sound turned down, and a bottle of wine. There's pictures of you and I on the walls around me. The way that it was, it could have been, surrounds me. I'll never get over you hiding this way. Calling to ever let my feelings show, and I thought that being strong meant never losing your self-control. I'm just drunk enough to let go of my pain, to hell with my pride, let it fall like rain from my eyes. Tonight I wanna cry. I turn this sad song on all by myself. Sure, it'd be hard, know that you're gone. Should I unfold some old and lost love letters? It's gonna hurt bad before it gets better. I'll never get over you hiding this way. And I've never been the kind to thought that being strong meant never losing your self-control. I'm just drunk enough to let go of my pain, to hell with my pride, let it fall like rain from my eyes. Tonight I wanna cry. Strong man, never losing your self-control. I'm just drunk enough to let go of my pain, to hell with my pride, then fall like rain from my eyes. Tonight I wanna cry. And I've never been the kind to ever let my feelings show. And I thought that being strong man, I'm just drunk enough to let go of my pain, to hell with my pride, then fall like rain from my eyes. Tonight I wanna cry. 12 o'clock and it's a wonderful day. I know you hate me, but I'll ask anyway. Won't you come with me to a place in a little town? The only way to get there is to go straight down. There's no bathroom and there is no sink. The water out of the tap is very hard to drink. Very hard to drink.
Why did I even sign up for this? I didn't know we had to practice auditioning. It's not fair. Everyone will be looking at me and judging me. Even if I make one mistake, everyone will notice and laugh at me. I'll be so embarrassed. There'll be lights shining in my eyes and my hands will start shaking like crazy. My throat will get all dry. And I'll stutter like there's no tomorrow. And I'll fidget. And I'll play with my hair. I'll get so nervous. What if I suck? What if I'm horrible? What if people start throwing things at me? Or worse.
tell everyone else about my performance and how bad I suck. And then I'll be embarrassed everywhere I go. There'll be no escape. People will remember me as the person who couldn't perform, the person who couldn't even talk in front of a crowd. I don't want to do this. I hate performing. I would use any excuse in the book to get myself out of this. And I know what you're all thinking. Just pretend to be sick. Well, I've tried that and it didn't work. Or use a doctor's note. I've also tried that. Turns out I'm not as good as I thought at forging signatures. They didn't even buy the damn pet excuse. Actually, you know what? I might not be too bad. I mean, I know my lines, and I've practiced for hours. All I have to do is get up there and perform it the way I know I can. The way I've performed dozens of times in front of my mirror at home. And then I'll be fine. No, I'll be better than fine. I'll be amazing. I just have to stay calm and relaxed. And the point is to have fun, right? I don't have to be the best. I just have to be the best I can be. I can do this. I can do this. I can do this!
Yeah! Yeah.
Give me up, 'cause I would really, really love to stick around. Do 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 do.
what is what, but they don't know what is what, they just strut.
A tiger, don't lose no sleep, don't need opinions from a shellfish or a sheep. Don't you come for me, no, not today. You calculated, I got your number, 'cause you're a joker. In a minute, get used to it. Funny, my name keeps coming at your mouth, 'cause I stay winning. Lay 'em up like swish, swish, bish. Another one in the basket.
I'm making hits with Katie.
Swish, swish, bish. Another one in the basket.
Just strut.